Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com, your home for everything Lakers. What a game one victory for LA. Anthony Davis, massive performance, 30 points, 23 rebounds, got to the free throw line 8 times. He even blocked a shot backwards. I don't know if you guys saw this, but blocked Andrew Wiggins while facing the wrong way. Just an unreal performance from Anthony Davis. So what can we expect for game two? Well, Anthony Davis talked a little bit about that after game one. Going to dive into that. But first, quick note here. Coming up tomorrow on Thursday, game two, come hang out with us. We're going to have a game two watch party for Lakers Nation. It's going to be at State Social House in West Hollywood. Doors open at 5:30. Use the Party Shark app to register to come hang out with us. I'm going to put the link in the description down below. I'll be there. A bunch of the other Lakers Nation staff members will be there hanging out, watching game two. So come watch game two with us, State Social House in West Hollywood. If you're not able to make it there for that, we will have our normal watch party over on Playback. Sean Davis and Jeff Spiegel will be there. Playback.tv/Lakers Nation if you want to watch that game with them remote, or you can come hang out with us in person, West Hollywood State Social House tomorrow. Again, doors open at 5:30, and don't forget to use the Party Shark app to sign up so we get an idea how many people are coming. Putting that link in the description below. Hope to see you tomorrow night for Lakers Warriors game two. All right, let's get into a little bit about what Anthony Davis said after game one. This is pretty important here. Here's what he had to say. So he, talking about game two, said it's going to be a different game. They're going to make adjustments. We're going to make adjustments. The building will be a little bit louder. Obviously, they don't want to go down 0-2. The crowd will be more into it. He also added, I'm going to continue to be aggressive. I know our guys are going to continue to be aggressive. Obviously, we know Draymond likes the help. So if they do decide to put him on me, figure out ways I can be effective with him doing his thing defensively. But who knows? I mean, we'll see what happens in game two. If they make adjustments, if they don't, still try to find ways to attack. So this, look, music to the ears of Lakers fans. Now, of course, much easier said than done. We've heard Anthony Davis say the right thing at the right time before and then not necessarily follow through in terms of promising to be aggressive. But still, nonetheless, good to hear that he wants to continue to be aggressive and be a factor in this game. We've seen instances, we saw this in round one, where AD can wind up getting schemed out of games, particularly in the offensive end. And I actually liked a lot of what we saw the Lakers do in order to free up AD, in order to get him opportunities going at the rim, in order to get him scoring chances. We saw a lot of pin down screens from guards and things like that that put AD in advantageous situations, and he did a great job capitalizing. So now, as Anthony Davis mentioned, there's going to be adjustments. That's what playoff series are all about. They're about adjustments and adjustments to the adjustments. So the question for Anthony Davis now and the Lakers, it's going to be, what are the Warriors going to throw at you? How are they going to adjust? AD mentions Draymond Green defending him a bit more. I do think that's a wrinkle that we will see. More Draymond Green on Anthony Davis. Wouldn't surprise me if we see some doubles as well. And if that's the case, if that's what happens, number one, how do you continue to keep Anthony Davis involved and engaged on the offensive end and keep him to be a force there? And then secondly, what do you do in order to move the ball from there? What's your read once that double comes? Or if you're dealing with Draymond Green and AD maybe doesn't have quite the same speed advantage that he enjoys when he's in a face-up position against Kevon Looney, how do you react to that? How do you handle that situation? Those are going to be very important counters for the Lakers to figure out ahead of game two. Another thing that I'm going to be watching for the Lakers to really work on or really focus on is the zone defense. What do the Lakers do when the Warriors throw a zone at them, which we saw? They also went smaller. They pulled Kevon Looney late in the game, and that was part of the Warriors' 14-0 run that allowed them to tie the game late. Now, fortunately, the Lakers had great resilience, managed to get the win anyway. But if we do see a lot more zone defense coming up in game two, how are the Lakers going to take advantage of that? Remember, I say this all the time. You have to punish teams for their choices, right? So if the Warriors go zone, they're going to be giving up some things. That's going to mean some more open outside looks for the Lakers in theory. Now, the Lakers shot just 24% from three in game one. That's been pretty normal for their shooting in round one, even of the playoffs. They just did not shoot the ball well from three. So if the Warriors go zone, the Lakers are going to need guys like D'Angelo Russell, Austin Reeves, Dennis Schroeder, LeBron even. These guys are going to have to be able to knock down threes. Speaking of LeBron's threes, that might be an adjustment in and of itself. He has not shot the ball well from deep this postseason. Maybe dial those back just a little bit. But As far as AD goes, if the Warriors do go zone, one of the ways that he can continue to be effective is by just being a force on the offensive glass, particularly if they go zone while pulling Kevon Looney from the game. Then AD, the way he can make an impact, the way he can continue to be effective in a different way is by being just an absolute monster on the offensive boards. And we know he has the capability of doing that. So for the Lakers, the key here for game two, Anthony Davis says, I'm going to be aggressive. From the Lakers' perspective, it's how do we continue, regardless of what the Warriors throw at us, how do we continue to get high-quality performances out of Anthony Davis? Because he was, in a game with LeBron James and Steph Curry on the floor, Anthony Davis was the best player in game one by far. It was not close. So how do you perpetuate that and continue to get these incredible performances out of AD? Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Don't forget, come join us, State Social House, West Hollywood, tomorrow. Doors open at 5:30. Going to be a good time. Register on the Party Shark app. Again, dropping the link in the description down below. Hope to see you there. Till next time, everybody. See ya, and stay safe.